Do you have a friend who wants to know what happens to your body when he takes Viagra? My name is Eduardo García Cruz. I am a urologist. I have been helping men who have problems in the sexual sphere for more than 15 years, and in this video some of you have asked us to explain a little better. Because we have a video in which we also talked of this. Let's explain a little better what happens to us when we take sildenafil, when we take Viagra. Sildenafil is a medication that belongs to the family of phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitors. There are four. They are sildenafil, vardenafil, tadalafil and abanafil. These four are available in Spain. There are a few more in other parts of the world and they all work more or less similarly. Sildenafil in Spain basically has two presentations. We have tablet pills and we also have an oral spray. Basically what we do is we take the pill, the tablet or the spray and our body absorbs it. It reaches the stomach, it is absorbed and it takes approximately between 30 and 60 minutes. Minutes to be effective, so there you have the first tip. If you take it and wait 5 minutes, it will not be enough. You have to wait between 30 and 60 minutes. What happens there? What sildenafil does is circulate throughout the body and inhibits phosphodiesterase 5. What does phosphodiesterase 5 do? Well, phosphodiesterase controls the caliber of the penile arteries. Okay, now I have two penile arteries, just like you, my penile arteries are closed. They are closed by a series of muscles that, since I am not in a neurotic situation now, those arteries are closed and very little blood reaches my penis. What sildenafil does is make these arteries dilate more easily. What it will do is that if this situation becomes erotic, my arteries react faster, they open and then more blood reaches the penis. Phosphodiesterase 5 controls the tone of these arteries through. It is a very complicated process. But where nitric oxide basically intervenes, which I have told you about in other videos on the channel. Basically it is a substance that is a vasodilator. Okay, so, what I was telling you, what sildenafil Viagra does is facilitate the opening of these arteries, which is why many men when they take sildenafil explain that they have an erection with less desire. That is, in a situation that is somewhat erotic, but it is not very erotic, you will have an erection more easily. And that is also why some men experience it as having more desire. Although that is not exactly the case, because sildenafil does not pass through, it does not reach our brain, it crosses the blood-brain barrier and therefore you will no longer have desire. What will happen is that with less desire you will trigger a faster response. Or, for example, if you are having sex and at a certain moment you get distracted, very typical when putting on a condom, if something happens, what sildenafil will do is keep your arteries open and, therefore, you keep your erection better. That's why you may have the feeling that you have more desire, because the erection is not interrupted by other external causes. However, I also want to explain to you many studies when they looked at this data, whether sildenafil, whether Viagra increased sexual desire. And basically what they found in the studies is that it does increase sexual desire. Because this has a catch. The studies were done on men who had erectile dysfunction. So, a man who has erectile dysfunction knows, and this is something that happens everywhere in the world, that he has less desire than he had before having an erection problem. And when you take Viagra what happens is that this desire comes back, you have the same desire you had before, but logically, when you have an erection problem, you turn off your desire. Sometimes you avoid sexual intercourse and that is why you get the feeling that you have less desire and that what Viagra does is increase your desire, although we know that this is not the case. Another thing that happens, another effect that sildenafil produces, and this is very curious, is it increases the time of intercourse. Intercourse time is basically how long you last in bed. There are many studies over the last few years, and I honestly thought they were wrong, but I see it more and more in consultations, men who take sildenafil and what they explain is that it is more difficult for them to reach orgasm. And that is why sildenafil is a molecule that if you have premature ejaculation and also have erection problems, which is a quite common combination, this type of medication, the inhibitors can help you because one of the things you may notice is that it will take longer for you to reach the orgasm. Another thing you may notice is that, when men reach orgasm, we go through a phase called the refractory period. The refractory period is the one in which we lose the erection and no matter what we are doing, no matter the erotic stimulus, we are not going to have an erection again. It is going to take a certain amount of time. What sildenafil does is shorten that phase. What it achieves is that, after orgasm, you can get an erection more easily and quickly. That second erection is also going to be easier. This is another thing that sildenafil produces very commonly. Another thing you can notice, because sildenafil in the end is a vasodilator, It is a vasodilator that is very specific to the penile artery, the penile arteries, but that can sometimes vasodilate other parts of the body. And then there we have the side effects. For example, we can have a headache and stomach pain, which are the two most common side effects of any medication. But we have other side effects that are related to sildenafil that are very curious. One of which is that it produces vasodilation in the arteries in the face, and that is why you may notice that you turn red. It can also produce vasodilation in the pituitary inside the nose, and that is why you may notice that mucus is falling, as if you were constipated. And a very curious side effect that also has to do with sildenafil is that there is a phosphodiesterase in the retina that has to do with our perception of color. Sildenafil can affect the perceiving cells, which help us perceive color, and what it does is that 2% of men have a bluish tint with their vision. These are the side effects, what you can notice, what happens to your body when you take sildenafil. Many men are worried about the side effects of the medication. What will happen to me with the side effects? And there is an important fact. First, sildenafil does not produce serious side effects. If the probability of a serious side effect is remote, it can produce these side effects that I mentioned, which are usually mild and well tolerated. One fact, a statistic that is interesting about any medication is what is called the dropout rate due to side effects, which is basically how many people stop taking the medication because of the side effects. The abandonment rate of sildenafil due to all these effects is 1 in 20. Therefore, it is a super safe, super effective medication. It causes very few problems. I have talked to you in other videos about heart problems, sildenafil, which we know is not the case. Sildenafil does not cause a heart attack, does not cause angina, does not cause sudden death. Therefore, it is a medication that works very well, which has few side effects, and that they are well tolerated. So, if you have an erectile dysfunction of psychological origin and you are thinking about taking sildenafil, or if you have any other problem in the sexual sphere, we have created a series of courses to help you improve. They are especially designed for these problems that we deal with on the channel. You have them in the description of this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to the channel. You know that I have a friend that we have a lot of videos about men's health, urology, sexuality, and that we are also on Instagram, on TikTok. We are doing live broadcasts at 10 p.m. Spanish time, 3 p.m. Mexico time, on Sunday. I hope to see you there if you have any questions. All the best.